Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and a very good morning to all of you. Hope you're doing fine. Today we are going to learn a lesson, Forces That Shape Earth, from your science textbook, Macmillan and McGraw-Hill, page number 284. Please open the page number 284, and here we go with the first part. We will study weathering. The topic for today, the part one of this lesson, is weathering. This is the lesson number 4 from chapter 5. In this lesson, we are going to study weathering, what is weathering, and the types of weathering, physical weathering and chemical weathering, and what are the agents which cause weathering, like freezing water, moving water, plants, animals. So here we go. We'll start with the first point. What is weathering? We all know that weathering is the breaking down of rock into smaller pieces by natural processes. Weathering is a breaking down of rock into smaller pieces by natural processes. There are two types of weathering. Physical weathering, it is also called as mechanical weathering. And the second type of weathering is chemical weathering. So first we'll begin with physical weathering. See, this is the breaking down of rock. This is a type example of physical or mechanical weathering. And we all know the physical weathering is the breaking down of rocks by physical changes. If there are physical changes occurring due to the agents like freezing water, moving water, plants or animals, in over a very long period of time. This doesn't occur in a very short span, but it takes a lot of time. It takes a very long period to cause these physical changes and to break the rock. So we'll start with the agents that are causing weathering. Number one, the first agent what we are going to study is freezing water. Frost wedging occurs when water seeps into a crack in rock and freezes. We know that water expands when it freezes. The liquid water takes less space, but when it freezes, when it becomes ice, it expands. It takes more space. It needs more volume. So the freezing water expands and forces the rock apart. Initially, when the water was in a liquid state, it enters into the crack of rocks. When there are cracks in rock, the water enters inside the cracks, and there, due to the extreme low temperatures, this water expands. It becomes solidified, the water freezes, and it expands. When it is expanding inside the crack, it is applying force in the crack, and it's causing the rock to break apart, to widen the cracks. Here's an example of a rock that has broken down, because of the freezing water. The next agent causing weathering is moving water. It carries pieces of rocks. As the water churns and splashes, the rock pieces collide with each other and break apart. It depends on the speed of the water. If the speed of the water is high, if the water is flowing with a high speed, then it can also carry bigger, larger rocks. And when it is slowing down, it will drop the rocks there and it continues its way on. So while moving, water carries pieces of rocks, and as the water churns and splashes, the rock pieces collide with each other and break apart. Here we see how the water is carrying the rock pieces, and we all see how the rocks are in the way of the moving water. So this causes weathering. Here also the moving water, we see how the moving water has caused weathering of these rocks. Then the next agent causing weathering is plants. Plant roots can enter cracks in rock. Like we have studied just now, the water enters in the cracks and there it freezes and it's breaking the rock apart. Like this, agent, plants also have their roots entering into these cracks in rock. As the roots grow larger, these roots, they apply force inside the cracks to widen. So now eventually what happens, this rock breaks. So the plant roots are causing the rocks to break, to weather. We'll just see the pictures, how the plants are causing the rocks to weather. Here we see a very, very big crack here. And here also we see how the plant roots, they are causing the rock to break apart. Here there's an example again. Here we saw how the root of this tree, it has broken this rock into two pieces. The next agent what we are going to see is animals. Animals also play a role in weathering, but not directly. We know burrowing animals like ants, worms and moles, they bring rock pieces from undersurface to the surface. They'll bring the rock pieces to the surface and thereby exposing these pieces to weathering. So the burrowing animals play an important role in weathering of the rocks. Here we see some examples. We see how the animals are playing role in weathering of rocks. See here, this is a burrowing animal. And here we see how an ant is just bringing the rock pieces, particles outside. And here we see another burrowing animal. So next type of weathering is chemical weathering. Chemical weathering is breaking down of rock by changes in its chemical composition. When we studied the physical weathering, it was the breaking down of rock due to physical changes. But here in chemical weathering, the rock is breaking down, the weathering is taking place due to some changes in the chemical composition of the rock. In this particular type of weathering, oxygen and acids are the most powerful agents of chemical weathering. Here we see oxygen and acids. We see an example here. We all know that rock contains a lot of minerals and different types of metals in it. So when a rock that contains iron, it is exposed to air and water, then a chemical reaction occurs in which oxygen combines with iron and forms rust. When the rock containing iron is exposed to air and water, then there is a chemical reaction occurring, which results in the formation of a rust. We all know a rock with rust, a rusty rock is not as hard as the earlier rock without rust. So now because of the rust, the rock becomes weaker and it easily breaks. So this is one example of chemical weathering. We'll see another example here. We all know we have carbon dioxide in air, and this dissolves in rainwater to form carbonic acid. This is a weaker acid, and this carbonic acid, when it falls on limestones, it can cause a chemical reaction, thereby causing the weathering, causing chemical weathering. There can be caverns, there can be cavities formed inside a rock. We all see here how the chemical weathering has caused, how these rocks have changed their color. We see the rocks behind this with not changed, but here these rocks have changed their color. We see the reddish color here. This is all because of the chemical weathering. Here, this is all because of the chemical reaction between the types of metals, minerals that the rocks have, and the air and water in the air. So this is a type of chemical weathering. This is another example of the same chemical weathering. Here we see how the rust formation has taken place, and we see a piece of rock falling down due to this rusty appearance of this rock, due to this chemical reaction that has caused the formation of rust inside the rock, thereby weakening it and ultimately it causing the weathering of this rock. Here we have seen how there are cavities formed in the rock because of the chemical weathering, and it looks like a honeycomb. So we call this as a honeycomb pattern of weathering. Here also there is an example of a chemical weathering. We see how the rock has got some honeycomb appearance. Here also we see a lot of holes inside the rock because of the chemical weathering. This is all because of the acid acting upon the rock and a chemical reaction. Here and we see a lot of examples here of chemical weathering. Here we see how the water has stagnated over the rocks, and how the water is, you know, it has changed its initial composition, and now the water, which has become a weak acid here, now it's reacting with the rocks, and we see how the rocks are weathering off. We see how the holes are forming here, and how the rocks have begun to weather off. So this is an example of chemical weathering. So this is the end of this topic, weathering. Then let us just review what we have learned in this topic. We have learned what is weathering, and we have learned the two different types of weathering, physical weathering or mechanical weathering, and the chemical weathering. And we have seen how the agents of weathering have brought the changes in the physical composition of the rock, thereby causing it to break. So we have studied how the freezing water has caused the water weathering of the rock, how the moving water has caused the weathering of the rock, and how the plants and animals have caused weathering of the rock. So hope you enjoyed the lesson, hope you understood the lesson, and I would request you all to just go through the reading book, the textbook, page number 284 and 85, to better understand the lesson, and later on we'll carry on with the next part of the lesson. We have still erosion, deposition, and the soil, which will continue in the next lessons. So hope you enjoyed. Thank you very much for watching this lesson. Thank you.